Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to my Atlanta Braves franchise mode series here in MLB The Show 16 on the PS4. Now, we are in the month of March. That means later this month, we will get the release of MLB The Show 17. Can't wait for that. The Atlanta Braves series will be carrying over. I do like this rebuild we've got going. Heck, can you even call it a rebuild if we're in first place after the All-Star break? I don't know. The youngsters are doing quite well here, and we got a lead on the Washington Nationals, who, oh, by the way, we play in a three-game set here in Atlanta at Turner Field. Now, one of the interesting things about when we import this franchise into MLB The Show 17 is that we will be able to play in the brand-new Braves ballpark. So that is definitely one of the perks of continuing this on, not just building this roster to the contender and then hopefully the powerhouse in the division that Atlanta is used to being. So many years making the playoffs, we want to get back to that with this ball club, and we want to do it in the new stadium, so it'll be a perfect opportunity to check out the brand new ballpark in the game. One of the things I'll talk about before this video is over is about what we're going to do with franchise outside of the Braves franchise, what's going to be covered on Sports Gaming Universe this season. I'm thinking there should be a new franchise, something we start completely from scratch. I think we should also retire a franchise, if not two. Yeah, Chicago Cubs franchise, I'm looking at you. The rosters are getting quite old now, and that's not really like the only determining factor of retiring a series, but you know, I kind of want to play with newer rosters in at least some of the franchises, so maybe putting the Cubs one to rest, which is carried over for several seasons now, might be the best. Hey, we won a World Series there with that one. And that's the goal here with the Braves and with any franchise that we do, is become World Series contenders. So far in this game, you see nothing doing on either side. No score for the Nationals, despite having a couple runners on there in the first inning. Now we go to the bottom of the first, and we got Josh Harrison at the plate. And, well, he's popping it up on the infield. So we're not going to get anything in our half of the first inning either. And we go scoreless into inning number two. Pick it up in the top of the second. Tehran pitching with a 3-2 count and two outs. That one's going to be a little too high. Call ball four, take your base. So Tehran's going to have to work with a runner on. And we'll see if he can go ahead and just leave it at one runner on. He's got a 1-2 count, and that pitch is going to be put in play. Harrison makes the play, takes his time throwing to first. I think they're kind of tweaking that stuff next year where you don't go ahead and nonchalantly throw over. Meanwhile, the runner hustling down the line beats out what should be a routine play. They've promised us that some of that is worked out, although that one was an out, no problem. Here's Freddie Freeman with a base hit up the middle. It gets through to center field, and he is on. Single for Freeman, and hopefully getting this Braves offense charged up in the bottom of the second inning. 0-2 count now. And this is going to be Thompson. He puts it in play. Same result. A base hit right over the mound and up the middle. Runners at first and second now. Now the Braves got something cooking. All right. Let's keep it rolling. Now with Dansby Swanson at the plate, he's going to put this in the air. And it's a high deep fly ball to center field. It's staying in the park. But wait, where'd my auto base running go? I hit the tag up button. And luckily, I have enough time to get over there. But I usually do auto base running because I screw those things up. Why was it making me make the tag decision? I don't know. Anyway, 3-2 count with one out. Runners at the corners. Echevarria is going to hit a ball to center field. This one, even deeper, out at about the warning track. And what? Okay, where's my auto base running? You've got to be kidding me. You cannot be thrown out at the plate on a ball that deep. We needed that run. Come on. I get hosed. You know, I actually checked in between those plays, between the first one and the second one, that my auto base running was on. It was, but it wasn't activating. I don't know. I don't get it. Anyway, foul ball. Freddie Freeman trying to track. Right fielder there too. Freeman over the shoulder. Has just enough room, and then he just kind of keeps bouncing off the tarp. Yep, yep. Hopefully he can get unstuck and make it to the dugout in time for his next at-bat, or at least for his team's next at-bat. That's Conforto putting the ball in play. They're going to throw to first base, and he is out. So despite a base runner, the Braves get nothing on the board this time around either. We are still scoreless after three innings at Turner Field. So while we're waiting for that first run of the ball game to be scored, let's talk about franchises and MLB The Show 17 a little bit. Oh, hold on. That's deep to left. And, well, there's your first run of the game. A leap, but he cannot bring it back. That's a home run for Matt Wieters. And it is 1-0 Nationals. They take the lead here on the road. That's his 10th of the season. It goes 373 feet. And how close was he to bringing this back and robbing a home run? Will we get a look at it? Sure we will. Cue that replay. Goes opposite field. Wieters gets just enough, obviously, to get it over the fence. But let's see. The leap? I can't really tell. It was a row or two back. Wasn't going to make that catch. So 1-0 Washington. 1-2 count. Looking to get Jason Worth out. And whoop. That breaking pitch stayed up in the zone a little too much. That's an opposite field home run. Back-to-back jacks for the Nationals. This time it's Jason Worth circling the bases. And just like that, two straight hitters get away from Julio Teheran, and it's 2-0. Washington, of course, liking their offensive output in this half inning. Solo home runs back-to-back. Worth goes 365 feet, and it's his 18th on the season. So kind of a quiet crowd now all of a sudden at Turner Field as things not really going the way of the Braves at this point in the ballgame. As you're going to see a replay now, Jason Worth's shot, the second of back-to-back shots. Now, just as in my Joe Broadway series where the Yankees are in first place and they can't draw a crowd, this crowd looks a little bit better in the lower bowl, but what is up with all those empty seats still? This is a young team, not only contending, but in first place after the All-Star break. Freddie Freeman already has a hit. Here's hit number two. He goes opposite field and lines a single. After that stinging hit there, he'll be on first base and hopefully leading the rally for the Braves. They've had runners on before. Let's hope that we don't make any base running gaffes. Here's going to be Thompson following that up with a base hit to right. Runners at first and second. We've seen this story before, but can we keep it going in this inning and get a run or two across the board, maybe tie this thing up? Well, let's find out. Echeverria at the plate. Oh, check swing in the dirt, strike three. Nope, it's ending right there. Rally killed, and I don't know how you say that name. Giolito is pitching a pretty good game so far, getting himself in some situations, but then getting himself right out of them as well. Whoa, okay, misjudged that a little bit maybe, but the fly ball finally caught, and no further damage done against us there in the top of the fifth. Let's go to the bottom of the fifth now, and the top of the lineup. That's going to be Lagares lining that right at third baseman. That's Anthony Rendon making the play, and frustration a little bit for the first place Braves, throwing that helmet down in disgust, inning over. So before those back-to-back home runs, I was trying to talk and introduce the idea here of what we're going to do for a new franchise this year. Dansby Swanson gets one out, but then trying to complete the double play, throws that into the dugout. A little careless right there. Runner will advance to second on the overthrow, and then Matt Wieters, who's already homered, will take a walk. Some more trouble right here for your starter, Julio Teheran, who's getting up there in pitch count, and that one's laced to center field. I think he might be done now. That runner coming around third, trying to score. He will do that ahead of the tag. 3-0 Nationals. This game not trending very well for us right now. So, as they come to give Teheran the hook, I want you guys to start thinking about who you want, and I know you guys all have favorite teams, so I'm sure we'll see a blend of everybody in Major League Baseball, but who do you guys want to see as a new franchise? I'm going to narrow it down to about four or five choices, like I did last year, and I will put a poll vote out at some point to help determine what that franchise will eventually be, but we're in the early stages, the embryonic stages of planning this right now, and I've got the month to think about it, or the better part of a month here now, before the game comes out, and I want to have my decision made. So we'll go through the process, but I want to just start by asking you guys to tell me in the comments here in this video and others that we'll cover for MLB before release on who you want to see the franchise team be, and more importantly, why. Give me convincing, compelling reasons, as this ball almost hit out of here. That is off the base of the fence. Freddie Freeman 3-for-3. Now runners at second and third. We still have not scored a run, but we have two in scoring position after the double right here. Like the way Freddie Freeman's swinging the bat today despite our troubles scoring runs. Actually, was that off the top of the wall? That was really close to a home run. Will we get a run home? Dansby Swanson. No! Strike three. He can't connect and inning is over. Once again, we strand base runners. So as you tell me the teams that I should consider for MLB The Show 17. Leave me compelling reasons why I might choose those franchises. I mean, are there prospects I should be aware of? Are there different dynamics that would be fun? Something you've never seen on my channel before? Something that just, obviously, you're going to say because they're my favorite team or whatever, but I want more than that. I want to hear some good reasons why I would be compelled to play through on a franchise. And it doesn't necessarily have to be like a rebuild like I was doing here, that I would consider this Atlanta Braves franchise. I would consider any team, whether they are stacked or rebuilt. You know, the rebuilds are fun. It doesn't always have to be that kind of a thing. You know, if you think there's a team at a crossroads here where maybe some hard decisions need to be made with veterans, and are we going to send some people out and start anew, or are we going to build around them? Here you see a double against Michael Fulmer, and already down 3-0. It's not looking good as Zimmerman comes up with an extra base hit. The way we have not been able to score runs today despite having base runners on, well, we needed to play right there. We had the drawn in infield, and it's a single, making it 4-0. This game starting to feel quite out of reach at this point. Might have to just kind of regroup for games 2 and 3 of the series. That one's lined sharply down the left field line. And wow, he's going to go, even though that is hit ahead of him, and he's going to slide in safe. So aggressive base running pays off right there. And the fifth run of the game, just 90 feet away. Try to turn two here and get out of the inning. That kind of sums up the day. Just kind of an awkward lollipop throw that goes to the screen, and it's now 5-0. We had no prayer of turning a double play right there. So, bottom of the eighth inning. We got two frames left to make some noise. We need base runners. That's what we need, and that's a fair ball over the bag. Next year, or soon, in MLB The Show 17, you may see that one curve down really into the corner there with the new ball trajectories we're going to see introduced into the game. Atlanta fans getting a little bored right now, as you see that Harper has to go out and tend to a beach ball that has come on the field. That's one of those cutscenes that plays very, very rarely, but it's kind of fun when those things pop up, just like that one and the one where a player lets go of his bat and flies into the crowd. They're timed nicely because you don't want to see them all the time. It would be annoying. But once in a while, just thrown into the code is pretty cool. So Freddie Freeman, 3-for-3. He's got two runners on. Can he make it 4-for-4? Oh, it's up the middle, but no, that's where they're playing it. Steps on the bag for one, throws the 1-for-2, double play, kills the bottom of the eighth inning, and we still have nothing across the board. 9 hits, no runs. Take it to the ninth inning now, still 5-0, 3-2 count. Thompson's going to find the gap. That might be extra bases as it rolls to the fence. He'll be standing on second base with a ninth inning rally. Well, I don't know. People not getting too excited because they've seen base runners on all game. What is that, the 10th hit we've had? But no runs. Now we have two outs. 1-1 count. Flowers going to chop that one. Third baseman Rendon throwing over to first, and the game is over. The Nationals take game one by a score of 5-0. We drop a game in the standings as these Nationals are creeping closer. We have to check and see what happens in the rest of the series as well. Jonathan Papelbon comes in to, well, not save it. They're up 5-0. Jason Worth is your player of the game. He goes 3-for-4, has a home run and 3 RBI. We lose 2 out of 3 in the series, but salvaging that last game gives us a little breathing room because now we stay at 2.5 games above the Nationals in the standings. We still have first place for now. We'll see if these youngsters can hang on to that or if they're going to wilt under the pressure. That'll do it for this episode. Like I said, leave me thoughts on who the MLB The Show 17 franchise should be and why, and I'll be looking those over. We'll see you next time.